Welcome to Bonnie Scotland. Welcome to Loch Lomond, land of Robert the Bruce, etc., etc. And welcome to introduction of the first Buteyko School Conference in Glasgow, 21st of April 2008. Way back when I first got involved with Buteyko, I spoke with several consultants at York Hill Hospital. The idea being that I could work with children. However, Dr. Payton suggested to me that would be difficult because parents would have to comply with anything I wanted the children to do. And in a fit of pique, I said to them, one day, children will present Buteyko in the Scottish Exhibition and Conference Centre. And that dream became a reality last Monday when five schools, with 40 children from each school, presented work on Buteyko's theory. How did it happen? Well, Michael Hughes was a PE teacher at St Maurice's School in Kindorrit. He's also a football player. And he was finding it really difficult to perform, having to take time out from games because of his increasing difficulty of controlling his breathing and his asthma. That prompted him to look onto the internet and eventually come and do a course with me. Michael was an excellent student. He wanted to learn more. He really enjoyed seeing his body heal and his stamina improve. It's some moral and ethical dilemmas with his job as a physical education teacher, because he knew that the medication that the children took to relieve their symptoms actually made their condition worse. And he found it difficult that when children were participating in physical education, that they had to take medication prior to starting the class. From this, he contacted me and we had several discussions. We met with Laurie Byrne, the head teacher, and it was decided that we would try the Buteyko method and pilot it in St Maurice's and see what difference it made to some of the children with asthma. We must have taught about 150 children in St Maurice's school, and all of them saw great benefits from Buteyko. There were a few who came along who didn't really want to be there. They came to get out of class, but they fell by the wayside pretty early on, and most of the students were diligent, did the exercises and saw the benefits. Some of the children are excellent athletes, some in running, some in swimming, some in gymnastics and some in volleyball. And last year, St Maurice's came out top in the basketball ladies team in the under 12s. And many of those children had been through the Buteyko Institute method. Further on from there, there was another teacher, Anne-Marie Farn from St Columbus, who came along because she had a dreadful problem with allergies. And she frequently goes out to Africa because she raises money to support a school in Olaleni. And Anne-Marie found it very difficult that she would have recurrent chest infections following on from the sinusitis when she went to Africa and then when she came back. And that prompted her to look in the Yellow Pages and she came up with my contact details. And she came along and did the course. Again, she knew there was a huge amount of children in her school that had asthma and concentration problems and behavioural problems. It's in an area of great deprivation, a high priority area as we call it here in Scotland. And Anne-Marie thought that it would be a good idea, or she had the notion that it would be a good idea that we could introduce Buteyko into the school and introduce it as a health education programme. So again, we met, had several discussions. We met with Maureen McGlinchey, the head teacher, and then we decided that we would pilot in a small group and then roll it out to the rest of the school once we saw how the classes were going along. We've been in St Columbus for just over a year. We've taught over 100 children there, but Anne-Marie, also being the head teacher for health education, decided that she would put it forward to the Education Authority as an innovative award so that the school could be known as a health promotion, health education school. These awards are quite prestigious because it gives the school points. Like, universities need to get research points for publications and research that's carried out. It brings in grants. Being a health promotion school brings in grants from the National Health Service in promoting health education throughout the schools. So we went ahead for the award. Angela Sim came out from Western Bartonshire Education Authority, and St Columbus got the highest award. They got a grade 3A because they're breathing themselves free of asthma. From there, Anne-Marie took this idea to the cluster group. There are several secondary schools, that's secondary education, and we have primary schools or junior education. And several of the junior schools, also with a high incidence of asthma, were anxious to be involved in the project. So we went along to St Noonan's and St Joseph's, and children from the ages of 5 to 11 were presenting at a conference on work that their original work that they had produced. When I spoke to Michael back at St Maurice's, he is keen to get St Michael's involved, which is another junior school in Moodysburn, and having spoke to the head teacher there, she put forward a pilot of pupils, just a small number, to see how it would roll out. And again, all of these pupils presented at the conference last Monday. As I said at the conference, I did have a dream that one day children would present at the Scottish Exhibition and Conference Centre, and I never really believed that that would happen. But all of those 200 children helped me to live my dream, not just dream it, on the 21st of April. Where do we go from here? Well, many of the MSPs and politicians couldn't make it. We held the conference on the first day back at school after Easter break, and the first day back at Parliament after the early recess. So it was difficult for ministers to take that first day away. But what it has done is they've asked for the information, and I have been invited to join the cross-party group for asthma. This is a group, a working party, that look at the best way to manage asthma within Scotland, and they advise the health minister. I've also been invited to meet with several councillors in Western Bartonshire. Two of the councillors would like to come to the school in St Columbus or St Joseph's or St Union's and observe the children doing their exercises. We're going to arrange this for late May, early June. And then I will be meeting with Angela Sim from the authority, Moni McGlinchey, head teacher, and Anne-Marie Farn, head teacher of health education, to look at how we can fund this project and get it fitted neatly into the curriculum in all schools so that nobody has to worry about a child having an asthma attack or worry about a child dying in an asthma attack again. I also spoke to a lady who is the Director of Lifelong Learning and Education, and she wanted to inquire about training the trainer. And the ideal situation is not for me to go into schools and continue teaching children, which is absolutely wonderful and it's the best job I've ever had, but it's to train the trainer. Train a teacher in every school. I'm sure there must be 365 schools in Glasgow or more. But teach a teacher in the school to be a buteyko practitioner, and then no child will be frightened of asthma again. No parents will be frightened, because as a child enters school, they can be taught the Buteyko Institute method as part of their curriculum, and that way there is a practitioner in school at all times should anybody have an asthma attack, and can teach them how to manage that. We're also looking at going into nurseries or kindergarten so that we get the 3 to 5 year olds, the preschool group. That way the behaviour isn't as learned and it's much easier to reverse. Also, our children's airways are not mature until the age of 5. So to actually get in and be able to reduce or discontinue the medication that actually damages children's airways means that we really have turned a corner with Buteyko.